Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Dear students, Assalamu alaikum. Hope you will be in good health. This is the fifth lecture of numerical analysis. Today's topic is the Hermite polynomial using divided differences. In the last lecture, we also discussed the Hermite polynomials. But if you remember, I told you that Hermite polynomials can be computed with the help of the theorem, which we discussed last time, along with example. And the second case was to compute Hermite polynomial using the divided differences. Divided differences, this is not new for you because you already know how to construct the divided differences table and how to find out the polynomial using the divided differences. In previous techniques, you saw that in case of divided differences, you saw that if we're having n plus 1 number of data points, then we can find out polynomial of degree n. But in case of Hermite polynomials, if there are n plus 1 number of data points, then we can find out polynomial of degree 2n plus 1. How 2n plus 1? That will become clear to you from this table. Let's assume we are having three data points, x0, f of x0, x1, f of x1, and x2, f of x2. But remember, we need the derivative of the function at these data points also. Mean that we need f prime of x0, we need f prime of x1, and we need f prime of x2 for the construction of the Hermite polynomial. How I can get the polynomial of degree 2n plus 1? Because in this case, the value of n is equal to 2. When the value of n is equal to 2, so 2n plus 1 will give you 5. So we can find out polynomial of degree 5 for this particular example. How? Let's look at the data points. I have in x0. I repeat x0 again. X1. Let's repeat x1 again. X2. Let's repeat x2 again. I call this x0 as z0 and this x0 as z1. X1 is z2 and x1 equal to z3. X2 is equal to z4 and again x2 is equal to z5. I renumber these points. I repeated the data points and then renumber them. So you can see now, if I go just for z i's, so z0, z1, z2, z3, z4, and z5. So you can see that your n is equal to 5 now. And number of data points are 6. When you are having 6 data points, then the techniques which you did before the Hermite polynomial, you can find out the polynomial of degree 5. But slight modification in the construction of the divided differences table. Now we have the data points. Now I need values of the function at these data points. So let me call this as f of zi. F of z0 is equal to f of x0. F of z1 is equal to f of x0. F of z2 is equal to f of x1. F of z3 is equal to f of x1 again. f of z4 is equal to f of x2, and f of z5 is equal to f of x2 again. You can see in this case, f of z0 and f of z1, they are the same, and both are equal to f of x0. Similarly, f of z2 and f of z3, they are the same, and they are equal to f of x1. F of z4 and f of z5, they are the same, and that's equal to f of x2. You can see, I use the notations for divided differences, if you look at them. But you know that the zero order divided difference is the same as value of the function. So it doesn't matter if I'm writing, I'm using this notation, I'm using this notation, it doesn't affect. Now let's construct the divided differences table. So let's go for first divided difference. As usual, when you are computing f of z0, z1, first divided difference, then you are saying that f of z1 minus f of z0 divided by z1 minus z0. Or this is equal to f of x0 minus f of x0 divided by x0 minus x0. So you can see that we are getting 0 by 0. We are in trouble now. But let me take you to the definition of the derivative of the function. Let's assume having x is equal to a, I'm computing derivative of the function f at x is equal to a. So this is the standard definition which you already know. Yeah, if h is the step size, so I can say this is f of x1 minus f of a divided by x1 minus a. Limit h approaches 0. When h approaches 0, so this x1 will approach to a, and a is my x0. And when I use this limit, I'm getting 0 by 0 from here. And in case of the definition of the derivative, we are saying that if this limit exists, 0 by 0 form, you can play with them, you can use the L'Hopital rules, you can simplify and get rid of the factor which creates the problem. So if this limit exists, then we say that that is the derivative of the function at x is equal to a. If I remove this limit, so it means that f prime of a is approximately equal to f of a plus h minus f of a divided by a plus h minus a. Yeah, f of x1 minus f of x0 divided by x1 minus x0. Remember, if this limit exists, we say that its approximated value is equal to f of a prime 8a. In other words, I can say that this was a 0 by 0 form, if h is equal to 0. And that gives you the derivative of the function. So if I compare this with this first divided difference, this minus this divided by this minus this, which becomes 0 by 0. So that's the reason this first divided difference has been replaced by derivative of the function at x is equal to x0. So that's the concept hidden over here, that this first divided difference will be replaced. Since I'm getting 0 by 0 form from here, so we replaced it by approximated value of the derivative of the function. So 0 by 0, we replaced it by f prime of x0. And you know that from the data, this is known quantity. If I'm come to this, if I'm coming towards this one, f of z1, z2, first divided difference is equal to f of z2 minus f of z1 divided by z2 minus z1. Yeah, f of x1 minus f of x0 divided by x1 minus x0. So you can see that we don't have the problem and we can find out this value. That's why I replace this first divided by difference by the exact value. Similarly, now let's come to this one. F of Z2, Z3, first divided difference is equal to F of Z3 minus F of Z2 divided by Z3 minus Z2. Yeah, that is equal to F of X1 minus F of X1 divided by X1 minus X1. So again, you can see that you are getting 0 by 0 form. So remember, this first divided difference has been replaced by derivative of the function at the point x1. We are getting 0 by 0, so we replace that by the derivative of the function, and that's the approximated value coming from here. Now let's come to this value, f of z3, z4 is equal to f of z4 minus f of z3 divided by z4 minus z3, which is equal to f of x2 minus f of x1 divided by x2 minus x1. And we don't have the problem. This is not 0 by 0. So we wrote the exact value coming from the first divided differences. Similarly, let's come to f of z4, z5. Is equal to f of z5 minus f of z4 divided by z5 minus z4. Yeah, that is equal to f of x2 minus f of x2 divided by x2 minus x2. And you can see that again we are getting 0 by 0 form in this case. So we can't compute the first divided difference in this case. That's the reason we replace this value by derivative of the function at x is equal to x2. You can see it x is equal to x2 here. So you can see that you are, this is a, you can see the derivative at x is equal to a. So we replace this divided difference by derivative of the function. That was the only change when you are constructing the divided differences table. And the change occur in first divided differences column only. Rest, there should be no problem. So now let's come for second divided difference. Second divided difference, f of z0, z1, z2 is equal to f of z1, z2 minus f of z0, z1 divided by z1, z2 minus z0, which is equal to x1 minus x0. So again, you can see that there is no any problem. F of z1, z2 minus f of z0, z1 divided by z2 minus z0. So remember, you are not getting 0 by 0 anymore. So this is the actually computed divided difference, which is the first entry of the second divided difference. Now let's come to this one. Find out the divided difference. So that will be f of z1, z2, z3, which is equal to f of z2, z3 minus f of z1, z2. And you can see that these values are different from each other. So I don't have the problem with it. Divided by z3 minus z1, z3 minus z1, which is equal to x1 minus x0. And again, these are two distinct values in the interval. So that's the reason I'm not facing any problem of 0 by 0. So we computed the actual divided difference in this case, which is given by this value minus this value divided by z3 minus z1, and z3 minus z1 is x1 minus x0. So we don't have the problem with it. Now let's come to the next divided difference, which will be f of z2, z3, z4. This value minus this value, and they are two different values. Divided by z4 minus z2. Z4 is x2 and z2 is x1. So x2 minus x1. Again, we are not facing the problem of 0 by 0. So we computed this divided difference. You can see this value minus this value divided by Z4 minus Z2, and Z4 minus Z2 is equal to X2 minus X1. Again, we got the entry of second divided difference. Now let's come to the next. This value minus this value divided by Z5 minus Z3. So this value is different from that value. Z5 is X2, Z3 is X1. So again, we are not facing any problem, and that's the reason we computed this value, which is the entry of the second divided difference. Now you can see this value minus this value, they are different from each other. Divided by Z5 minus Z3, Z5 is X2 and Z3 is X1. So we don't have the problem in the calculation of this entry. So if you are having more data points, so remember you have to proceed in a similar way. I mean that if you are having, for example, X3, then you have to write X3 twice. So you will have Z6 and Z7, they will be equal to X3. But again, you will be facing one case where you will be getting 0 by 0s, and then you have to replace that situation by the derivative of the function at X is equal to X3. How many points do you have? You have to go accordingly. Now let's go for the third divided differences table. So for third divided differences table, now let's compute the value. So I computed the value here. F of Z1, Z2, Z3 minus F of Z0, Z1, Z2. There are two different values. Divided by Z3 minus Z0. So Z3 minus Z0. That's X1 minus X0. Again, we don't have any problem. We computed this divided difference. Now let's come to the next one. Z1, Z2, Z3, Z4. F of Z2, Z3, Z4 minus F of Z1, Z2, Z3. Which is there? And there are two different values, which is clear from the last column. Divided by Z4 minus Z1. So you can see that your Z4 is X2 and Z1 is X0. So again, we are not facing the problem of 0 by 0. So that's the reason we computed this value. Let's come to the next value. F of Z2, Z3, Z4, Z5. We have to reach up to end point. That is equal to F of Z3, Z4, Z5 minus F of Z2, Z3, Z4 divided by Z5 minus Z2. So Z5 was X2 and Z2 was X1. So this is not 0 by 0 form again. So we computed the next entry of the third divided difference. Don't have more entries, so let's go to the next divided difference, which is the fourth divided difference. Fourth divided difference will be F of Z0, Z1, Z2, Z3, Z4. And that is equal to this value minus this value divided by Z4 minus Z0. You can see that these values are not equal. So numerator is non-zero. Z4 was X2. Z0 was X0. So again, they are two different values. And that's the reason we are getting here this value. It's not 0 by 0 form. So this is the actual value which is coming from the construction of the divided differences. Now let's come to the next one. F of Z1, Z2, Z3, Z4, Z5 is equal to this value minus that value. And you can see that these are two different values. Divided by Z5 minus Z1. Z5 was X2 and Z1 was X0. So again, I'm not getting 0 by 0 form. That's the reason we replace this value by the actual value we are getting. This is equal to this value minus this value divided by Z5 minus Z1. Z5 is X2, Z1 is X0. So this is not 0 by 0 form. This is the actual value which is coming from your calculation. And two entries, so one entry more, that's the fifth divided difference. Fifth divided difference is F of Z0, Z1, Z2, Z3, Z4, Z5. And that is given by this value minus this value, which you can see over here, divided by Z5 minus Z0. Z5 minus Z0. So, if you remember the data, Z5 was X2 and Z0 was X0. So, again, this is not 0 by 0. This is the actual value which is coming from the division after two numbers. Since we reach up to the single entry, so we stop here. And this is the procedure how to construct the divided differences table in this case. The only problem which I can see, that's the construction of the first divided difference, because you are facing the case when there is 0 by 0. So in case of 0 by 0, we use the derivative of the function at that particular data point. The rest of the construction of the divided differences table is familiar with you. The procedure, how to find out the first divided, the Newton forward formula and the Newton backward formula. That is the same as you did in case of divided differences and as you did in case of the differences. In case of Newton forward divided differences, we were using the first row. In case of Newton backward divided difference, we were using the last row. Similarly, we do in case of Hermite polynomials. So let's see that what the Hermite polynomials are. The first Hermite polynomial is the forward polynomial, the forward case, and that is given by polynomial of degree 5. I use f for forward. F of Z0, this is the first divided difference. This is the first divided difference, which was coming from the column. And actually, you can see that this value was F prime of X0. Z1, X minus Z0. Since this is the function of X, so X minus Z0, but the value of Z0 was X0. So that's the reason I have written here X minus X0. Next case, this is the first entry of the second divided differences column. Multiply by X minus Z0. So, X minus Z0 is X minus X0. Multiply by X minus Z1. Again, Z1 was X0. So, again, X minus X0. That's the reason you can see X minus X0 square here. Then plus. Let's come to the next column. This is the third divided differences first entry. Multiply by X minus Z0, which is equal to X minus X0 here. Multiply by X minus Z1, which is equal to X minus X1. That's the reason I'm writing square here, because Z0 and Z1, they are the same and the value is equal to X0. So I'm getting square here. Multiply by Z minus X minus Z2, but Z2 is equal to X1. So that's the reason you can see another factor over here. Now let's come to the next column. You can see data. This is the first entry of the fourth divided differences. Multiply by x minus z naught, which is equal to x minus x naught. Multiply by x minus z1. Again, z1 is equal to x naught. So again, x minus x naught. That's the reason we are writing square here. Multiply by x minus z2. Z2 was equal to x1. So that's the reason I'm writing x minus x1. Multiply by x minus z3, but z3 was equal to x1 again. So that's the reason you can see square here. Plus. Fifth divided difference is first entry. Multiply by x minus z0, which is x minus z0 into x minus z1. Is equal to x minus x naught whole square, because z naught, z1 are the same. Multiply by x minus z2 into x minus z3. Z2 and z3, they are the same. That's equal to x1. That's the reason you can see square here. Multiply by x minus z4, and z4 was equal to x2. Since we don't have more entries, so we stop here, and this is the forward polynomial. You can see, if you stop here, polynomial of degree 1, if you stop here, polynomial of degree 2, if you stop here, polynomial of degree 3, if you stop here, you will be getting polynomial of degree 4, and if you stop here, you will be getting polynomial of degree 5. And that's the reason you can see for 3 data points, we got polynomial of degree 5, which is clear from here again. Now let's come to the backward polynomial. Again, it's under the Hermite polynomials. You know that in case of backward, we are using the last row. We are using the last row. Last row in your table was corresponding to. So you are having f of z5. This is the last entry of f of zi's. In this particular case which I am going to consider. Plus, this is the last entry of the first divided differences column. Multiply by x minus z5. But z5 is x2. So that's the reason you can see x minus x2 here. Plus, this is the last entry of the second divided differences column. I have written that f of z3, z4, z5. If we go in backward direction, multiply by x minus z5, z5 is equal to x2, into x minus z4. Again, z4 is equal to x2. That's the reason you can see square there. Plus, this is the last entry of the third divided differences column. Multiply by z minus z5 into x minus z5 into x minus z4. Since z5 and z4, they are the same and they are equal to x2. So that's the reason I can see x minus x2 square. Multiply by x minus z3. Z3 is equal to x1. And you can see that this is the term you are getting. Go to the fourth divided differences column. This is the last entry of the fourth divided differences column. Multiply by z minus x minus z5 into x minus z4. Z4 and Z5 are the same. That's the reason I'm writing and they're equal to X2. I'm writing X minus X2 square. Multiply by X minus Z3 into X minus Z2. Z2, Z3, they are the same and they're equal to X1. That's the reason you can see square there. Plus. Last entry of the fifth divided differences column. And that was the only one entry. X minus z5 into x minus z4 gives you x minus 6 to whole square, because z4, z5 are the same, equal to x2. Multiply by x minus z2 into x minus z3. Z2 and Z3, they are the same, that is equal to X1. That's the reason you can see X minus X1 square. Multiply by X minus Z1, Z1 was equal to X0. So you can see in this case, in case of backward, you are also getting polynomial of degree 5. If you stop here, polynomial of degree 1. If you stop here, polynomial of degree 2. If you stop here, polynomial of degree 3. If you stop here, polynomial of degree 4. And if you stop here, that gives you the polynomial of degree 5. Since we have taken 3 points, so corresponding to the 3 points, we can find out polynomial of degree 5. I can't go for higher degree in this particular case. So this will be the formula for the Hermite polynomial using the forward case, and this will be the formula using the backward case, Hermite polynomial. B I'm using for backward, F I'm using for forward. So this is the general case which we discussed. Now let's consider an example. Find Hermite polynomial using divided differences for the data, and the data points are with you, in front of you. X f of x f prime of x is given by. So I can say that this is x naught, f of x naught, and f prime of x naught. Similarly, x1, f of x1, and f prime of x1. x2, f of x2, and f prime of x2. These are 3 data points, and in case of Hermite polynomial, we are expecting polynomial of degree 5. So let's construct the divided differences table. In case of the divided differences table, these are the data points, and you can see that I have repeated the point data point 0.1. So 0.1 again, 0.2, so 0.2 again, 0.3, so 0.3 again. So you can see this is Z0, Z1, Z2, Z3, Z4, Z5, as we discussed in the last table. Let's find out the values of these functions. So this is f of 0.1. So f of 0.1 is given by this value. You can see this entry over here. And again, let's repeat this value, f of 0.1 again. So you can see that these are the same values. F of x2, f of x2, this is f of x1. F of x1 is f of 0.2, and which is given by this value. And you can see that this is the value I'm writing over here. And again, f of 0.2. So this is your f of 0.2. 0.3, this is f of 0.3, so you can see that we are having f of 0.3, and this is 0.3, so f of 0.3 again. So you can see that I repeated the values from the data. Now let's construct the divided differences table, the problem you are facing. First divided difference, this value minus this value divided by this minus this. You can see these two values are the same. These two values are the same. So I'm getting 0 by 0. That is the reason we replace this value by derivative of the function at 0.1. And you can see this value is the derivative of the function at 0.1, which is coming from there. If you come to this one, this value minus this value divided by 0.2 minus 0.1, this is not 0 by 0, so you can find out this value, similar to the divided differences. Now let's come to this value minus this value divided by this minus this. You can see these two values are the same, these two values are the same, so you are getting 0 by 0. That's the reason we replace this value by derivative of the function at 0.2, which is this value. And you can see the value comes here. So this value is the same as given in your data. Now, for the next entry, this value minus this value divided by 0.3 minus 0.2, you can see these two values are different, these two values are different. We don't have the problem, so let's compute this value. That's the value we have computed. Come to the last one, this value minus this value. divided by this value minus that value, but you can see this value is the same as this one, this value is the same as that one. I'm getting 0 by 0. That's why we replace this entry by derivative of the function at 0.3. And this is the derivative of the function at 0.3, which comes over here. So this value is the same as that one. Rest, find out the second divided difference in a similar fashion. This value minus this value divided by 0.2 minus 0.1. We don't have the problem. We can find out this value. Similarly, this value minus this value divided by this 0.2 minus this 0.1. Again, we don't have the problem and we can find out this value. We computed this value. Similarly, this value minus this value divided by 0.3 minus 0.2. We don't have the problem and we computed that value. Similarly, this value minus this value divided by this 0.3 minus 0.2. So remember, in second divided differences, we skip the central point. So we skip this number. So 0.3 minus 0.2, we don't have the problem. So we compute this value. We got the column corresponding to the second divided difference. Now let's come to the third divided difference. This value minus this value, but third divided difference, you have to skip two central values. This value minus this value divided by this 0.2 minus this 0.1. We skip these two central values, but remember, they are different. They are different, so we don't have the problem. We computed this value. Similarly, this value minus this value divided by this 0.3 minus this 0.1. We don't have the problem, so we computed this value. And finally, this entry minus this entry, you can see they're different from each other, divided by 0.3 minus 0.2. We don't have the problem, so we computed this value. Completed the third divided differences column. Now let's come to the fourth divided differences column. So, this value minus this value, fourth, you have to skip three central entries. This value minus this value, divided by this value minus this 0.1, so we ignore these three central values, we don't have any problem over here, so that's the reason we computed the value, and that's given by. This entry minus this entry, again, they are different from each other, divided by 0.3 minus 0.1. We skip these central values, but we don't have the problem, and we computed that. So, computed the four divided differences column. Now, let's come to the, because we reach up to the last one. This entry minus this entry divided by last 0.3 minus 0.1. We don't have the problem. We computed that. And this is the fifth divided differences table. Since we got the single entry, so that completes the divided differences table. Now, as usual, when you are computing the polynomials, so remember, this value plus this value multiply by x minus 0.1. That will give you polynomial of degree 1, which I will show you in the next slide. That will be polynomial of degree 1, polynomial of degree 2. Plus this number multiply by x minus 0.1 into x minus 0.1. That's the reason you can see x minus 0.1 there. Plus this entry multiply by x minus 0.1, x minus 0.1, x minus 0.2, which is equal to x minus 0.1 whole square multiply by x minus 0.2. And similarly, this entry multiply by x minus 0.1, x minus 0.1. Which will be x minus 0.1 whole square, x minus 0.2 into x minus 0.2, that will be x minus 0.2 whole square. And polynomial of degree 5, this plus this entry multiply by x minus 0.1, x minus 0.1, x minus 0.2, x minus 0.2, x minus 0.3. And that will give you x minus 0.1 whole square into x minus 0.2 whole square into x minus 0.3. And that will be the polynomial of degree 5, which is the forward case. The values I have written in the next slide, but I'm just clarifying it from the table, so that will become clear later on. Now for the backward, this value plus this value multiply by x minus 0.3, that will give you backward polynomial of degree 1. We are plus this entry multiply by x minus 0.3 into x minus 0.3, which is x minus 0.3 whole square, and that will give you polynomial of degree 2. For polynomial of degree 3, you have to add this term, multiply by x minus 0.3 into x minus 0.3 into x minus 0.2, which will be x minus 0.3 whole square into x minus 0.2. That will be polynomial of degree 3. Polynomial of degree 4, you have to add this number plus this number, multiply by x minus 0.3 into x minus 0.3 into x minus 0.2 into x minus 0.2, which will be x minus 0.3 whole square into x minus 0.2 whole square. That is the polynomial of degree 4. And if you add this term plus this term, multiply by x minus 0.3, x minus 0.3, x minus 0.2, x minus 0.2 into x minus 0.1. That will give you the backward polynomial of degree 5. So let me go to the next slide. So I think the next slide will be clear automatically. These are the data points which I used. So you can see that this is the these are the data points which we were using, 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, repeated. And this is the first row of your divided differences. So I told you, this value plus this value multiply by x minus 0.1 is the polynomial of degree 1 which is coming from here. And if you simplify this, this is the ax plus b. This is polynomial of degree 1 forward. Remember this, I have written the first row of the divided differences table. Remember, for polynomial of degree 2, this value plus this value multiply by x minus 0.1 plus this value multiply by x minus 0.1 into x minus 0.1, and you can see that that is x minus 0.1 whole square. So this plus this term will give you polynomial of degree 2, and that's given by this relation. Polynomial of degree 3. So of course, polynomial of degree 2 plus another term, and another term will be this value multiply by x minus 0.1, x minus 0.1, x minus 0.2. And that is clear from here. This value plus this value multiply by x minus 0.1 into x minus 0.1, x minus 0.2. You can see that this is polynomial of degree 3. And if you simplify it, you are getting polynomial of degree 3, which is given by this expression. Polynomial of degree 4. We have to use this entry now. So this polynomial of degree 3 plus another term. This is coming from the first entry of the fourth divided difference table, which I discussed in the previous slide. Multiply by x minus 0.1, x minus 0.1, x minus 0.2, and x minus 0.2. That's the reason you can see squares here. And if you simplify it, you are getting polynomial of degree 4, which is given by this relation. Polynomial of degree 4, this polynomial plus this entry multiply by x minus 0.1, x minus 0.1, x minus 0.2, x minus 0.2, and to x minus 0.3. And you can see it over here. This multiply by the last value. So remember this, I reproduce the first row of your divided differences table in order to clarify the things for you. And if you simplify it, you are getting polynomial of degree 5. You got polynomial of degree 5, and you can see that this which we were looking for in case of forward. Now, The same thing which I discussed in the last lecture is that if you are getting polynomial, you can play with the polynomial. What are your requirements? You can study them. What are your requirements? You can study them. Yeah, you can do the interpolation. So the discussion will be the same as we discussed in the last lecture, that how you can use the polynomial in your projects which you are looking for. Now I have computed value of the function at 0.25. So this is the value. When I replace x by 0.25 in the polynomial of degree 1, so this is the value. And when we replace x by 0.25 in this expression, we are getting this approximated value. And when we replace x by 0.25 in this relation, we are getting this value. And when we replace x by 0.25 in this polynomial, you are getting this approximated value. And when you replace x by 0.25, you are getting this is the value. So you can see these are the approximated values of the function at x is equal to 0.25 using different polynomials. You can see that the polynomials are different, but when you are increasing the degree of the polynomial, that the numbers are going closer and closer to each other. And yes, that we are expecting. This was the case of forward. Now let's go for the backward. So again, I am reproducing the data points, and this time I reproduced to you the last row of your divided differences table. This is the last row of the divided differences table, and you can see f of z5, f of z4, z5, 3, 4, 5, f of 2, z2, z3, z4, z5, f of z1, z2, z3, 5, and so on. So these are the entries of the last row of your divided differences table. Let's go for the backward polynomial. Polynomial of degree 1, f of z5 plus this value multiplied by, start from the endpoint, x minus 0.3. You can see it over here, and if you multiply, simplify this, you are getting polynomial of degree 1. Polynomial of degree 2, this plus this term, multiply by x minus 0.3 into x minus 0.3, which is x minus 0.3 whole square. So you can see this number multiply by x minus 0.3 into x minus 0.3 whole square, and if you expand this, you are getting polynomial of degree 2. This backward. Polynomial of degree 3. This number plus 8 another one. This entry plus 8 another value. So this value multiply by x minus 0.3, x minus 0.3 into x minus 0.2. Which you can see over here. This is the value minus this value. And if you simplify this, expand this, you are getting polynomial of degree 3, which is given in terms of this relation. Polynomial of degree 4. Add another term. So I will be adding this term, multiply by x minus 0.3 into x minus 0.3 into x minus 0.2 into x minus 0.2, which is given by this relation. So you can see this value is that value, multiply by, remember in backward we are going from the endpoint in upward direction. And if you expand this, you are getting polynomial of degree 4, which is given by this expression. And polynomial of degree 5. So this plus another term, this term multiply by x minus 0.3, x minus 0.3, x minus 0.2, x minus 0.2 into x minus 0.1. You can see x minus 0.3 whole square, x minus 0.2 whole square multiply by x minus 0.1. So you can see this value, and this is the value which is this entry. And if you expand this, you are getting polynomial of degree 5. Again, you saw that you replace the data by polynomial of degree 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And again, these are the polynomials. What is the requirement of your project? You can play with this polynomial, because the study of the polynomial is not that complicated. If you are going for integration, yeah, if you are going for the derivatives, what is your requirement? So this will be similar as you did before. And now, for in case of interpolation, Let's find out the values. At x is equal to 0.25, so you can see x is equal to 0.25 lies between this value and this value. But that's not given in the data. So we replace x by 0.25 in this relation, polynomial of degree 1, and this is the approximated value. Similarly, we replace x by 0.25 in this polynomial of degree 2, and we are getting this approximated value. Replace x by 0.2 in this relation, and you are getting the approximated value which is given by this value. Similarly, replace x by 0.25 in polynomial of degree 4, and you are getting this is the approximated value. And when you replace x by 0.25, you are getting the approximated value given by this relation. So you can see that these are the approximated values of the function at x is equal to 0.25 using polynomials of degree 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Again, you can see that when you are increasing, the numbers are going closer and closer to each other. So when you are increasing the degree of the polynomial, your accuracy will be increasing. That's what we are expecting. And you can see the difference is the difference between these two is large. The difference between these two is smaller than the difference between these two. And similarly, the difference between these two is greater than the difference between these two. So this is the way how to do the interpolation using the Hermite polynomial. So in case of Hermite polynomial, you saw that we can replace the data by polynomial of higher degree. We can study that. What is the requirement of the problem we are dealing with? So definitely, if you're having some project, you're having some experimental data, you replace the data by the polynomial, and then you can get your required targets, as I discussed before. And if you are going the interpolation, then you can do the interpolation also. So you saw that Hermite polynomials can be computed using the divided differences technique, and we used the theorem. So it's up to you which method you want to use, which method is simple for you. You can find out the polynomials, you can do the interpolation, hope that the values will be very close to each other. Again, in case of any problem, please contact me. I'm telling you that whenever the institute decides, you will have your examination shortly. So try to listen to these lectures carefully. I tried my best. Enough material I tried to provide in these calculations so that everything is clear to you. Thank you very much.